What are the alternatives to minoxidil for hair loss treatment?
Minoxidil is often the first treatment you try when you experience hair loss. This is, of course, because it's readily available and over-the-counter without a prescription. While minoxidil does have some benefits for many people with genetic pattern hair loss, the effect of minoxidil has limitations. The application must be consistent, and there are often issues with your skin's tolerance, so many people don't want to continue this ongoing treatment. I'll discuss why many people eventually give up using minoxidil and the option of having more effective treatments for hair loss in comparison to minoxidil. I'm Dr. Amiya Prasad. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in the New York City and Long Island area for over 25 years. I've helped people with hair loss throughout my career, specifically with surgical hair transplantation. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, which is a non-surgical treatment for male and female pattern hair loss, which I established from 2011 to the present time. TrichoStem Hair Regeneration is the original treatment that inspired the use of ACell and PRP for hair loss as a treatment category. Our unique approach to the application of ACell and PRP has resulted in significant hair growth for 99% of our patients for over 3 to 5 years with only 1 to 2 treatment sessions. People with hair loss typically seek an alternative to minoxidil because they see some benefit in the beginning of its use, but then the minoxidil appears to stop working after a little bit of time. Minoxidil was originally a medicine used for high blood pressure and with a noted beneficial side effect for hair that ultimately became its primary use. While the exact mechanism of minoxidil's effect is unknown, it appears to delay the onset of normal hair shedding, and this part of the shedding phase is called the telogen phase. And it also appears to extend the active hair growth cycle called the anagen phase. By extending hair growth and delaying hair shedding, more hair is present, which gives the scalp more coverage. However, minoxidil doesn't appear to actually thicken individually thinning hairs, nor does it significantly slow down the progressive thinning of hair before permanent hair loss. If the regular application of minoxidil is stopped, which many people do after they note improved hair coverage, its effect can also stop quite abruptly, and it leads to a sudden, significant degree of hair shedding that can be often distressing. I find minoxidil to have limited value for long-term use as the benefits are less than optimal and rely on the daily scalp application. While the instructions say to use it twice a day, application once a day is sufficient due to the drug's inherent half-life. Many people report scalp irritation and redness from minoxidil, which can be relieved in many cases by using minoxidil foam instead of the liquid form. This is because minoxidil foam doesn't contain propylene glycol, the chemical used to break down the scalp skin barrier in order to allow penetration of this active ingredient. However, people using the foam will also complain of scalp irritation as well as other related issues like skin flaking and itching. For men, a limitation of minoxidil is that it does not affect DHT or dihydrotestosterone. DHT is an important factor in male pattern hair loss. Drugs such as finasteride or dutasteride can have a significant effect on the rate of hair loss progression, which minoxidil cannot. Unfortunately, women with female pattern hair loss do not have the option of using finasteride. Minoxidil is the only topical pharmaceutical treatment for female pattern hair loss. Since women are often prescribed spironolactone, which is a testosterone blocker, with some variable levels of benefit, that is an option. As of 2011, my approach to the medical management of hair loss changed after we used acellular matrix to enhance our hair transplant surgical results. I was using the advanced wound healing material called extracellular matrix by ACell to optimize surgical incisions for facelifts as well as other cosmetic and reconstructive surgeries. I applied this experience to help improve the healing of the donor area incision for hair transplant surgery as well as to improve the survival of hair grafts. About a year after surgery, I found that native thinning hairs in areas without hair grafts increased in number and was growing remarkably thicker. I started working in 2011 on combining extracellular matrix by ACell with platelet-rich plasma in an effort to see if I could create a standalone non-surgical procedure for male and female pattern hair loss. After several years of working on different formulations, treatment strategies, and techniques, I realized that we now had a system which can help men and women with hair loss without needing surgery. This treatment system, which I trademarked TrichoStem Hair Regeneration, has essentially been the most significant step in the management of hair loss since the introduction of finasteride in the late 90s. The success rate of treatment in men and women is over 99%, defined by an improvement in hair quantity and quality. Unlike the generic PRP or ordinary ACell and PRP treatments being offered in the marketplace, which require multiple treatment sessions, which is about every 1 to 3 months in the first year and continuing maintenance injections in the second year and beyond, most of our TrichoStem hair regeneration patients only need one or two treatment sessions with outcomes that sustain and last 3 to 5 years and longer. One of the things I do for my patients who receive TrichoStem hair regeneration is that I generally help them stop needing to use minoxidil. Most people are relieved by not having the burden of this twice daily scalp applications, which can be both irritating and cause your hair to look matted down and flattened. In fact, TrichoStem hair regeneration patients require no special shampoos or other topical therapies for maintenance. In my opinion, minoxidil is no longer a necessary part of hair loss management. We have created effective and convenient hair loss management strategies which can be used more predictably with significant benefit and long-term sustainability without the need for daily topical scalp treatment. I hope you found this information helpful. Thank you for your question.